So I'm really grateful for this meeting. I know it's like that corny, obvious thing to be grateful for, but really, like, this is the first time I've had a team of people all come together for a similar purpose, and it's just really cool to see this grow and this happen, and all of you guys be so excited about what you're doing. Having people on my team that are better than me at certain things, so like this can just grow even further, and I've always just been a solopreneur for the most part. You guys are absolute rock stars, every one of you, and I'm just very, very, very grateful for all of you. So thank you. And something that would make me feel alive today, I've been biking to the gym recently, and it just makes me, like, instead of sitting in LA traffic and like driving in a car, like biking is just so different and better, and I'm excited to take a bike ride to the gym today. There's a ton of dust on this lens. How are you?
Good, I haven't
Good
seen you in
to
a while.
see
I
you.
know.
I think the last video of mine you were in was Disney video. We're training back. Evan is here. Bart is here. You guys have
Hello.
never been to Gold's, yeah?
No.
No, never.
I can't believe you. That's crazy.
I know, and I grew up here.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The outside is nice.
Yeah, it's a lot bigger than it looks when you first go in. You think it's just one room.
Yeah, everyone's like, oh, it's so small. And then you're like, oh, just kidding.
Yeah, there's three other rooms, and I like how it's just one big open door where there's like all kinds of air that can just flow in.
Yeah, it's really nice. It's like my favorite area. And they just got the, like, out here, they just got those rigs. So before it was a janky ass platform and like a bench, but they just put that in, which is really nice. And there's like the tent, so it's not as hot. We're doing a little back today and a little shoulders today, just catching up on upper body training because I haven't done upper body training specifically since probably the last back day you guys saw. So let's go. If there's still gonna be stuff available on Friday when this video goes out for the new barbell launch, but I'm switching shirts from this. This is the tan shirt from Barbell. I just tie it up in a knot in the front, guys. I'll usually take it home and I'll cut off material like this much at the bottom, and then I'll just tie it in a knot in like the front or the back, and then that's it. Like, t-shirts can be cute in the gym, they don't have to be baggy, and train this.
Let you do some rope pull downs.
What's up, guys? We filmed most of that workout and it's been about a few hours now. I feel like I've been running around like a chicken with my head cut off today. It's just been one of those days where I booked myself second after second, but it's good. That being said, it's 7:30. I usually eat my last meal of the day around now. Honestly, I'm one of those people that's like, I'm not a night eater. I'm a middle of the day eater and I like to eat breakfast. So I'll usually eat my first meal around 8:30 in the morning, sometimes like 9:30, depending if I'm like busy in the morning or whatever. I will have a lot of my food in the middle of the day, and then around 7:30, 8 o'clock is like the end of my day of eating, and I've always been fine like that. I know a lot of, like, I feel like the large majority of people eat in the middle, sorry, at, like at night, like late night. Brian, you eat your last meal at like 11. And some people are like, I cannot go to bed without eating. I will be hungry. And I just don't get that. So I don't know. I'm going to have a protein shake. Okay, so shake is going to be protein mostly. That's like all I have left right now. Or macros. This has 4 grams of carbs and 1 gram of fat. I will have this just because it's a little easier on my stomach. As I get into a cut, every year it does not fail that my stomach starts to get sensitive to a lot of things like protein powder, like things that it's not sensitive to for the majority of the year. Only when I'm like deeper into a cut where my stomach is like, what the hell? Like, where are your micronutrients, Samantha? Oh, I'm gonna do almond milk first. And I need to be eating a little bit cleaner than normal. And that's actually one of the better things about a cut. Usually I'm hungry enough to be eating mostly micronutrient dense foods. Got lots of ice. However, this week, I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. I have been eating like a complete asshole. Like, I have not taken the time to prep my food. I have not taken the time to cook. Why did I do that? To cook nutrient dense food. Like we had a food at Brian's birthday and it was delicious. We cooked a bunch of chicken and potatoes and veggies. But for the majority of my meals, they have been like just not good meals. They've been like the least easiest thing to make or like a protein bar. And I've just been feeling like complete crap and I'm tired. And that is 1000% why. So we are healthing this shake up right now with help and vegan protein. And I also have a green juice. I got this from Organifi a while back and I was going to partner with them. I really like them as a company. Like, I really actually enjoy the owner. I met him and his girlfriend and they're great, but I just don't use it enough to promote it on my channel, I would say, just because, I don't know, you guys don't see me using green juice too often. So I felt kind of like weird promoting it. So I was just like, I'm not gonna, but I'm like, I need this. Sometimes life happens and like we're not always the most on top of our diets all the time. Like, I try my best to be, but I've just been so busy this last week that I'm just like, I gotta grab something to eat. And I'm like rushing out of the house and that ends up being a protein bar. And I'm like, I feel like crap. So let that be a lesson to you guys. If you feel like crap, it might be your diet. It might be like not eating enough really great foods. So my video editor, Emma, is probably watching this like, Amanda, be more vegan, you'll feel better, because she's vegan and she always tells me how great it is, and it's just like making me consider it, honestly. One of these. What else can I put in here? I don't have any carbs left. Protein. That's it. That's gonna be it. And by the way, you can get your PE Science Vegan Select on PEScience.com using the code Amanda for 30% off. Shameless plug. No, but in all seriousness, I've actually been using the Vegan Select way more often because now that I'm into this cut a little bit deeper, it's better on my stomach. It just feels better. And yeah, it's actually really great and it tastes really good. And speaking of tasting really good, let's try. Definitely tastes like green health. Tastes like a green juice. It's really thick and it's like massive. It's really great. It's delicious. Gotta cap this off and end my night here. I'll catch you guys in the morning. Just wanted to give you a little podcast update. Podcast stuff that went out this week. Mark Manson interview. So Mark Manson is an author of The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck. I listened to that on audio on the way from DC to Los Angeles on the road trip video, but I got to interview him and it's such a good interview. Also did Eating Out and Staying on Track. I was gonna make this a video, but I wanted to make it a podcast. It's 40 minutes long, so basically all my tips and tricks on what I do when I'm going out to eat and wanting to stay on track. You guys follow me on Instagram story, you see my macro estimating meals and stuff like that. When I go out to eat, I have absolutely zero stress when I go out to eat now because I've had so much practice doing it for myself. So go check out that podcast. I hope it's helpful. A lot of people said it is so far. Update on FOCA. FOCA is getting there. Seriously, it's like that's what I spend my days doing. You guys don't really see too much of like my day because I'm just sitting at my computer working on it. It's like the biggest project I've ever done. It's not just me, it's Will is writing 3/4 of it. My coach Will, he's like writing like content for like 3/4 of it. We have a couple of contributors, psychology person, Jerrica, sports performance coach, PJ Nessler, you guys have seen him in a couple of videos, and Kara Corey, FitLife registered dietitian. Couple of contributors on the project. Also, I'm writing 1/4 of it, and then we have like the marketing materials and like the web developer, and we're gonna be hosting some webinars. So there's like, I feel like half the people are like 100% yes, they're like already down to do it. A lot of you guys are in like the Facebook group, and like you know you want to do this course because it sounds like it fits for exactly what you need perfectly, which I'm excited about. And then there's still some people that have questions and wanna hear more and wanna hear from us. So we're gonna be hosting some webinars during the launch week. I'm like super sorry that we haven't announced the launch date yet. I know you guys are like waiting for it, but this is such an important project. This is such an important, it's a certificate course. It's like something that you finish and you move forward and teach other people how to guide them through health and fitness. So it's something that's really important to us, and we wanna make sure it's really great. And there's like a few things that have been popping up in terms of like making sure the course is interactive and making sure that it's like set and ready to go for when we do get it accredited in the future. It takes 1 year or 500 students in order for it to get accredited by like nationally recognized organization. So we wanna like prepare it for, like, we wanna like make sure it's prepared for when that process happens. We wanna set ourselves up for success. We want to set our students up for success who do join it, who are going to be enrolled in it, who are gonna be going through it, who are gonna be coaching other people. It's a lot to think about. So we're just trying to make it perfect. So thank you for bearing with us. We appreciate it. It's really nice of you guys. Those of you who are waiting and are interested in it, just bear with us. Just bear with us. I'm gonna end the video here. Thank you guys for watching today, and I will catch you guys in the next one.